Hello friends, today we will discuss about the microscopic Ohm's law. Now, microscopic Ohm's law is nothing but the when electric current in a material is proportional to the voltage across it, then material is said to be ohmic or obeys the Ohm's law. Means, if we increase the current, then voltage also increases, then material is nothing but the ohmic material or that material obeys the Ohm's law, and hence we can write I is proportional to V, means as I increases, V also increases. Okay, so a microscopic view suggests that this proportionality comes from the fact that an applied electric field superimposes a small drift velocity on the free electrons in a metal. So for ordinary currents, this drift velocity is of the order of millimeter per second, which are the order of the 10 raised to 6 meter per second. So the current density can be expressed as, now we know that the equation for the current density, we can write like this, I is equal to N E V into A, or we can write J is equal to I by A, and which is nothing but the N E V, A get cancelled, remaining term we get J is equal to NEV. Okay, but again we know that V is equal to IR. According to that Ohm's law, we can write the equation I is equal to V by R. Therefore, J is equal to, here in this equation, we just put the value of I is equal to V by R. Therefore, equation becomes J is equal to V by RA. And therefore, resistance R is equal to rho L divided by A. J is equal to V by RA, and again we know that as R is equal to rho L upon A, then J is equal to what we get here in this equation, we just put the value of R. Therefore, equation we get J is equal to V divided by rho L divided by A into A. Means here, instead of R, we just put the value rho L upon A. A get cancelled. The remaining equation J is equal to V divided by rho L. Again, we can write this equation like this, J is equal to E into L divided by rho L. Here electric field E is equal to V by L is there. Okay, therefore V is equal to what we get? EL. So V is equal to EL, this value put it in this equation, we get this equation. Okay. Again, ELL get cancelled, remaining equation J is equal to E divided by rho. Therefore, we get J is equal to sigma into E, where reciprocal of the resistivity is nothing but the sigma, that is nothing but the conductivity. And we get the final equation J is equal to sigma into E, and that is nothing but the microscopic Ohm's law. Now, next point we'll discuss about the superconductivity. Now, superconductivity is nothing but the resistivity of pure metals decreases with decreasing temperature. When the temperature falls below certain value, the resistivity vanishes entirely. Okay, so this phenomenon superconductivity was first observed in mercury by the professor H.K. Ohms in 1911. During the year 1911, the scientist H.K. Ohms discovered, or first observed the superconductivity in a mercury. Okay, he measured the electrical conductivity of the metal at low temperature. So the variations of the resistivity for a pure metal and semiconductor is as shown in this following figure. So this is the figure of resistivity is along y-axis and temperature is along x-axis. Now this graph shows for superconductivity and this is for the normal metal. Okay, now after that, however, Ohms discovered that the electrical resistance of highly purified mercury dropped to zero. So definition of the superconductivity is the property of the metal having resistance, or the property of the metal the resistance of which becomes zero at a critical temperature is known as a superconductivity. Or simply we can say that a resistance of the conductor become zero at a critical temperature is known as superconductivity. Understood? Next one, the temperature at which metal had passed into the superconducting state is known as a transition temperature. Or transition temperature means what? If the material changes its state from the normal state to the superconducting state, then it is said to be a critical temperature or transition temperature. So every superconductor has its own transition or critical temperature. So for pure metal, TC, for pure metal, TC may vary from 0.15 Kelvin to 20 Kelvin. And for ceramic material, it is found to be 90K. Okay. Now there are some important features of superconductor. Now first one is the electrical resistance drops to zero. This is the first feature of the superconductor. Okay. Now second one is the magnetic flux lines are excluded from the material. Now this is one more important property or features of the superconductor, that is magnetic lines of force are excluded from the material. Third feature is small change in thermal conductivity and volume. Fourth one is the volume of TC is low when the impurities are added to the element. When we added the impure material then or impurity, then the value of TC becomes low. Okay. Now next feature is ferromagnetic and antiferromagnetic materials are not a superconductor. Okay. Now next one is superconductivity is found to occur in a metallic element in which the number of valence electrons Z lies between 2 and 8. Okay. So these are the some important features of the superconductor. Now next point we'll discuss about the Meissner effect. Now the Meissner and Oceanfield, these are the name of the scientist discovered in 1939 that a superconductor completely expel any magnetic field lines that were initially penetrating it in to a normal state. The sample is in superconducting state and placed in a magnetic field. It is found that the magnetic flux is totally expelled from the sample. Suppose the magnetic field is applied first to the sample in the normal state as shown in figure A. If you see the figure A, then it is observed that in first figure material is in normal state where the temperature condition is T is greater than TC. Okay. Now from the figure A it is observed that magnetic lines of force are included or passed within the material. See here. Okay. Now let the material cool to below TC. In presence of the magnetic field, it is found that the magnetic flux is totally expelled from the sample. Now if you see the figure second, then it is observed that material is placed in an external magnetic field where the temperature condition is T is less than TC. Okay, the absolute temperature is less than critical temperature. So then it is observed that the magnetic lines of force are excluded from the sample or material. They are not passed through the material. Okay. Now, so this repulsion of the magnetic flux during the transition from normal to the superconducting state is called as a Meissner effect. So, when a superconducting sample is placed in a magnetic field, it induces current which circulate on the surface of the specimen in a manner that it creates a magnetic field everywhere equal and opposite to the applied magnetic field. Okay. Now, therefore, the magnetic induction inside the specimen we can write capital B is equal to mu 0 in bracket H plus M bracket complete, where the condition is given at the condition t is greater than tc. Now for t is greater than tc means when we put the material is in magnetic field, then B becomes 0. Therefore above equation mu 0 into H plus M is equal to 0. Okay, now here only mu 0 multiplied to this bracket equation mu 0 H plus mu 0 into M which is equal to 0. Therefore now this term shifted towards the right side. Therefore the equation mu 0 H is equal to minus mu 0 into M. Now again here mu 0 get cancelled, equation H is equal to minus M. Okay, so the susceptibility of the material psi is equal to M by H. Susceptibility of the material, now the susceptibility is nothing but the, it is the ratio of M indicates the magnetization. So susceptibility psi is the ratio of magnetization to the magnetizing field intensity, that is H. This ratio is nothing but the susceptibility. So from this equation M divided by H is equal to minus 1, and this M by H is nothing but the psi, and that is nothing but the susceptibility of the material. Thus the superconducting state is perfectly diamagnetic, or thus we can say that superconducting state is a perfect diamagnetic. Meissner effect proves whether a particular material has become a superconducting or not. So this Meissner effect proves that whether a particular material has become a superconducting or not. Okay. Now after that, next point we'll discuss types of the superconductor. Now we know that superconductors are classified into two categories, or the superconductor have namely two types, type first superconductor and another type is type second superconductor. Okay, now we'll discuss about the type first superconductor. Now type first superconductor, in type first superconductor the transition from the superconducting state to the normal state in the presence of the magnetic field occurs sharply at the critical value Hc as shown in the following figure. If we see this figure, then it is observed that at point Hc, now at this point superconductor having the transition or superconducting state of the material is converted into the normal state. Okay, now this figure shows the magnetization curve for a type 1 superconductor. Now this is the figure of magnetization M versus external field H. Now type 1 superconductors are perfectly diamagnetic below Hc and type 1 superconductors are perfectly diamagnetic when it is below Hc. Below Hc superconductor becomes a perfectly diamagnetic and completely expel the magnetic field from the interior of the superconducting phase, and during or below the Hc the magnetic lines of force passed through the interior of the material. Understood? So as the magnetic field increases, the magnetization increases, and add the particular magnetic field, it dropped to zero. What happened now after that? If we increase the magnetizing field, okay, if we increase the magnetizing field, the magnetization is also increases. Okay, at a particular magnetic field again it dropped to zero. Okay, the magnetic field can penetrate only the surface layer, or current can only flow in this layer. Thus this type or type 4 superconductors are poor carrier of the electrical current. This type of superconductor exhibit Meissner effect, that is this type of superconductor behaves as a perfect diamagnetic material and obey Meissner effect. Okay, Now, pure specimen. Pure specimen of most superconducting material are of type first, and they have very low value of Hc. Magnetizing field intensity value is very very low. For example, lead, tin, mercury, etc. Type first materials are called soft superconductor because the superconductivity is destroyed very easily at below Hc values. So this is about the type first superconductor. Now we'll discuss about type second superconductor. Now this type second superconductor, also known as a hard superconductor. This type of superconductors are characterized by two critical fields. That is lower critical field Hc1 and upper critical field Hc2. That means type second superconductor have another name is hard superconductor. Now in this type of superconductor, there are two critical fields were used. One is the lower critical field denoted by Hc1. If we see this figure, then it is observed that two critical field were used. So one is the lower critical field Hc1 and other one is upper critical field, that is Hc2. Now again, it exists in three state. That means in type second superconductor, three states where exist. One is the superconducting state, other one is the mixed state, and third one is the normal state. Below Hc1, the specimen is superconducting, that is diamagnetic. Now below this field, specimen or material is perfectly diamagnetic. Okay, at Hc1, exactly at Hc1, the flux start to penetrating into the specimen unit or until the upper critical field Hc2 is reached. At Hc1, magnetic flux start to penetrate into the specimen until the upper critical field Hc2 is reached. The specimen is in the mixed state and exhibits superconducting electrical property. Now during this process, the specimen means material is in mixed state, okay, and exhibit the superconducting electrical properties. So this specimen behaves as a perfect superconductor up to Hc1. Above Hc1, magnetization decreases and hence magnetic flux start to penetrate through the material. Means above Hc1 field, magnetization M decreases and hence magnetic flux start to penetrate through the material, and the mixed state is also known as a vortex state. Above Hc2, if you see this figure, then it is observed that above Hc2, what happened? The material behaves as a normal conductor. In the region Hc1 and Hc2, the material is in mixed state. But electrical, it is a superconductor. Type second superconductor can carry larger current when the magnetic field is between Hc1 and Hc2. That means when the superconductor having magnetic field is between the two fields, that is Hc1 and Hc2, at that time superconductor carry large current. For example of the type second superconductors are aluminium, silicon and vanadium exhibit type second superconductor. So these are the two types of the superconductors.